Hello everybody, I'm Danny and you're watching the Tennis Shoe Review. The shoe we're talking about today is the Babolat Propulse number 2. You'll see the vlog man behind me and he's hitting with Spencer. They're trying that shoe out right now. You know, this is a good shoe for me. I thought it was probably the best shoe that I've ever tried in the Babolat line. It's very comfortable. I'd probably prefer a shoe a little bit tighter. It's a medium width and I've got a narrow foot. You might see this shoe worn by Andy Roddick, and one noticeable thing about this shoe that they have that I don't see many shoes having is the foot belt technology. And it's a Velcro strap that's in the midfoot, and they also have one in the heel, and that gives you more foot support and stability. It's made for the aggressive tennis player, and for me, I thought it worked out great. Another good thing about this shoe that it's very well ventilated, and so that's a good combination for the aggressive tennis player. So for me, again, I thought it was the best shoe that I've ever worn in the Babolat line. Let's see what the testers thought. To my right is the vlog man, Christopher Edwards, trying out the Propulse number 2. I don't know what racket he's using, but it looks like an Adidas, not sure, but very small head size. Doesn't matter for him, except for that shot. Here he comes. Chris, can you tell me how these shoes worked out for you?
Yeah, good shoe for me. Very low to the ground in the forefoot. So I like that. I felt very fast in them, very lightweight. I would like them to be a little stiffer. You know, I felt the chassis of the shoe didn't quite have the rigidity that I would have liked. But with that said, the forefoot strap and then that foot belt around the heel helped a lot to lock my foot in. So, you know, I think the flex gave it some definite comfort. I think helped with traction because it allowed the shoe to flex and stay connected to the court well. But I'd like a little bit more stiffness through the forefoot. But, you know, as I said, the foot belt technology really made up a lot for it. And, you know, I felt pretty locked in.
You know, that's actually a good point. I think you said you'd prefer it to be just a tiny bit tighter in the foot support area. I actually thought the same thing. But the straps, for me, I actually thought helped out in that department a lot, and that you too as well.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if they widen this one. It feels a little bit roomier than the original Propulse fit. I have a narrow foot, and this one, you know, I found I had to really cinch the laces and strap it down pretty tight, stop my foot from sliding around in it. And then, you know, just felt a little bit too flexible on the forefoot. But, you know, I'm locked in. I would like a little bit more stiffness in there.
Thanks, Chris. Cool.
Thanks.
Next up is Spencer Bowler. He's an all-court player, and we like to call him Spenny the Blade. Here he comes to the front with a nice approach. Beautiful backhand winner against the Vlogman. Spence, how you doing? Let me know how these shoes worked out for your game.
Love them. I think I'll go ahead and start by saying these are my favorite play tests of the year so far for the shoes. I know Chris felt that they could use a little more stiffness. I felt they were just right. As a baseliner, as you know, it's important when you plant and turn, you have that support. I did feel it, and I thought it was great. Good combination of traction, stability, comfort, fit. Worked really well for my feet. I really enjoyed it.
Geez, that's going out a limb there, saying it's the best shoe of the year. That's nice to hear, because I actually thought it was the best Babolat shoe I've ever worn as well. How'd the durability work out for you?
So far, so good. Still going. I don't see any premature signs of wear. A little bit of wear in the normal spots on the ball of the foot and towards the toe there, but nothing substantial. I think it certainly is lives up to the durability guarantee.
Thanks, Spence. Next up is Jason Huang. I'd probably say Jason's probably the most improved playtester of the year, especially on his forehand side, which you can kind of notice right there. His volley's not so much, but he's still working on that. And here he comes. He does not want the point to end. Jay, how you doing, and how these shoes work out for your game?
I'm doing good. These shoes, I had really high expectations going into this play test. I really liked the original Propulses, and with these, I thought they improved on them. It's a wider fit, fits my foot a lot better. And that foot belt technology, I thought it was a kind of a superficial thing where I didn't think it would work, but once I tried it on, laced it up, and cinched it up, it was really, really good. And I really felt the stability there. So, like Spencer said, this is probably up there with one of my favorite shoes of 09, up there with the Ballistic 1.3. Really nothing bad to say about it.
You know what I noticed about the shoe? Just, you know, there's good foot support, but I also thought the ventilation was really good. That was noticeable to me. I don't know if the tester said anything about that. What are your thoughts on the ventilation?
I totally agree. Yeah, it's the breathability was really good. You could feel it, especially last couple weeks. It's been really windy. You could really feel it cooling off your feet. So ventilation is top-notch as well.
Not only that, but I also thought that it plays lighter than what we listed at. I think we listed at 6.7 at size 10.5. Did you think it played lighter than what we listed at?
Yeah, I agree as well. It plays low to the ground, and it does play lighter than actual weight.
Cool. Thanks, Jay.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. Overall, you know, I think this was a very good test play. All the testers liked it. And again, for me, I thought it was the best Babolat shoe that I've ever tried. Some that I've tried in the past have been a little pokey, and this is just really comfortable. One thing I forgot to mention in the introduction is that this shoe actually does come with a 6-month guarantee, which also is another plus. Thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next time.